Coach Z, a lot of people don't really realize that wrestling in Division I is restricted to between 17 and 19 dates. You said 18.
18 dates.
18 dates. And as a result, a lot of people like to do they don't like to do an individual duel. They like to do tries, quads, or duel in the morning here, drive up there, whatever it may be. Talk about how much the restrictive dates and losing Portland State hurt you guys date-wise.
Well, it didn't really hurt us date-wise. What hurts is just trying to get teams, you know, to come out and wrestle because, you know, we got wrestle someplace. We go to the Midwest. We're going to pick up two teams, you know. And a lot of times you might have Iowa State, you know, Minnesota, Wisconsin. They're pretty close together, you know. And that's why when you had Oregon down the road or Portland State up the road, you know, teams could come out and get two or three duels in one day or 2 days, but they get two duels. So, you know, that's one thing that really hurts us out here right now is we don't have that, you know, close team right by us.
You've lost two teams in the last 2 years within an hour and a half drive each of them. Do you think your administration is committed to keeping wrestling here at Oregon State?
Yeah, they're very committed. You know, they're very committed. You know, we got pretty good endowment. We just built a new wrestling room. You know, so we're very committed here. It's just that, you know, you can't be, you know, get stuck on an island sometimes.
So kind of you're paired up with Boise now. If people want to do it, they got to go and they got to drive 6 hours to Boise from here. So that's kind of who you're paired up with now. Otherwise, the next closest thing D1-wise is...
probably UC Davis.
UC Davis. Your brother.
My brother, yeah.
Okay, Coach, you are a member of the Rules Committee, okay? I want to get your take on how you feel the qualifier went. The NCAA qualifier really took bids away from the pack, correct?
Yeah.
How do you feel overall, though, even though your conference suffered, and maybe your team as a direct result, do you feel it was a fair system? Was it successful?
No, I think it's the most fair system. I think it's a very fair system. I thought it was very successful last year as far as the first year. You know, some tweaks here and there, but when you went back and look at it, I don't think there was one person that got left out of the national tournament that should have been there, automatically should have been there. Now, when you got down those last two, three qualifiers, you know, you could have went, you know, yeah, this guy might have beat the guy to qualify, but, you know, it's to me, it's the most fair system we have.
You said look at the whole body of work, okay, and you were talking about, and you know, one of your athletes got left out, but... And who I felt, maybe one of your assistants felt, should have gone. Do you still think that was the fair system, even though your 174 pounder got left?
Yeah, I think it is. I mean, it's done what you do all year. You know, what you do all year. You know, if you don't beat any quality opponents, you're going to have a hard time getting in. So, you know, you got all year to prove yourself. You know, you can, like I said before, I think some guys got in just because of the November they had. You know, some guys got in because of the late season. So, and I think it's been a fair system. And, I mean, anybody in the future can be on the Rules Committee, Selection Committee. And when all said and done, I think it was probably the best field that we've had.
Okay, there was kind of a unique situation. I believe Craig Henning did not place in the Big Ten last year and as a result did not qualify. Under the new system, would he have qualified?
Yeah, he would. He would have qualified, but it's just because of the year he had.
Okay, and he won. The body of work was great enough for him to qualify. So it's helpful for guys who might have a two-week slump in the conference tournament time, is what you're saying.
Yeah, it's not all based on the conference. You know, there's a lot of guys are going in, they're already qualified. You know, even though they might not have a good conference tournament, you know, they're already qualified. Where in the past, you had to perform at that conference tournament.
So for someone like Jay Jaggers, who may not have had such a dynamite year, had he had a bad tournament, he still beat enough quality opponents, he still would have qualified.
No, he still would have qualified.
Because he's an automatic from the year before.
No, it's not. You don't base on anything the year before. It's all based on that year. But he had enough body work that year that he still would have qualified.
Okay. Coach, you are on the Rules Committee, as I said, and you felt the qualifier system was very fair. Are there any other rules or anything else that we're going to see coming up here in the future that may surprise people or things that maybe they don't even know is coming?
Well, you know, we're discussing about going to a one-semester sport. There's been a lot of talk the last 10 years about going to a one-semester sport. And that's something right now we're looking at, talking about, putting a plan together. You know, starting, I think, the 2012-2013 season and maybe, you know, starting the season in January and ending, I think, the week after the NCAA basketball tournament. So that's something we're really looking at, trying to put a plan together. And so that could be coming down the pipeline here in 2013.
If you're Jim Zaleski, what's good about a one-semester season, a season beginning in January and ending in late March, April.
Well, I think it's better for the athletes coming in, young guys coming in. They don't have to jump in and worry about you know, the pressures of wrestling right away, making weight right away. They get their feet, you know, one of the ones we're doing is just before APR purposes to give them that first semester to get acclimated academically. And then, you know, also, you know, you start in January and you end up in April. We're hoping to get more media coverage, more media coverage at the NCAA tournament. We know we're not going to be fighting the basketball. Maybe, you know, by the time the tournaments roll around, we're not fighting the state high school wrestling tournaments, you know. So we're hoping that it'll increase attendance at those events.
So you're saying Jim Zaleski supports the media?
Yeah, why not?